Hello guys, it's Ago. 5 questions for you again. The only show where we bring you messages directly from the youth on various social issues. I'm Benjo with my co-hostess.
Hi, Art.
We are happy to be back with you again to share opinions of young people across the whole of Ghana on various issues that are important to us.
Today, we want to share thoughts on services and life in the community with you. Let's talk on a couple of issues first, then we see where the conversation takes us. Our topics are healthcare and sanitation.
So we asked the Ghana's SHS student population what their experience had been with getting access to basic healthcare when they need it.
It's incredible. More than 1 in 3 youth in Ghana said that they cannot always afford to be treated.
6 out of 10 youth we asked say that they sometimes have to skip getting care due to the high cost of their lack of funds at home. People whose parents also have low income find it difficult as well.
That's interesting. But how about the others? How are they able to access health care?
Well, of those that can afford care, 4 out of 10 of them say it's because of their NHIS cards. And a quarter of them who can regularly access care when they need it said it's because their family provides the support.
But also, let's not forget that it's not just about the access. We also have to talk about the quality of service provided at the hospital.
Exactly. Thankfully, almost 60% of young people say anytime they went to a health facility, the staff were friendly or administered effective treatment. I think that's a plus. A few even added that the nurses and doctors they visited are competent. Maybe young people don't get sick that much, but when they do, the majority seemed happy with their quality of care.
Yes, but how about the others? That leaves 1 in 3 young people who didn't say that the care that they received was good. A little over 30% of the youth who were not happy and stated that the staff were unfriendly or disrespectful, or they did not feel like they received the quality health care. Let's hope as the years go by, this number will reduce. Let's now shift our attention to something directly related to health, sanitation. We asked some of the youth in Ghana what they thought about open defecation specifically.
Open what?
Come on, I'm talking about emptying one's bowels in the open. You know, going free range instead of the toilet.
Okay. Can you share some of the responses you got?
Of course. So most people thought that going outside is not good. It's something that you do not approve of. This is surprising because 1 in 5 people as a whole in Ghana defecate in the open, and it's something we need to change.
Absolutely. Of those that say it's wrong, over half feel that it's a real health risk to Ghanaians as a whole, and 1 in 5 say that it creates a foul smell in the environment. But it would surprise you that as some do not agree. Out of every 20 youth in Ghana, there is one of them who think it's perfectly okay to defecate in the open. They are fine with going to the bush to do their business. For them, it's even safer, more convenient and healthy.
That's surprising. I wish we could keep talking on that, but we have to shift to a different topic. We also asked the youth of Ghana whether they are able to influence decision-making in their families and communities. We got some interesting answers. Most of them, about 7 out of 10, can have a say in life. Of those youths that have an influence, a third say that they are able to influence decisions on their education. A few others said that their parents do ask their opinions in decision making, and others have an influence on decisions that affect their community.
1 in 5 young people today in Ghana are not involved in decisions at all. Their parents don't ask their opinions, and others feel they are too young to be heard on family or community issues.
Well, I don't know about you, but I think the percentage of young people that can give their opinion will keep growing. We have important opinions to express. For example, to conclude, we asked Ghanaian SHS students what is their biggest issue in their communities. Can you guess what they said?
Money, jobs, safety.
No, no, and no. The biggest issue for the youth today is their community's access to clean water and sanitation, both at home and at school.
Fantastic. Well, this brings us to the end of today's segment. We are sorry to go, but you will definitely see us next time.
This has been Ago 5 Questions for You. Let's keep chatting on UNICEF Facebook and Twitter pages. Share with us your thoughts. 5, 1, 7.